excited. Say, I love it. Who's gonna win tonight? Who's gonna win tonight? I can't hear you. Who's gonna win? Parkhill, give me a big one. Max Moose. Everybody growl. Down the line, signs up. All right, looking good. This is Reagan, 4 and 84. I'm right for Reagan. He's got a Cubs hat on. My main man. All right, get your hand in the heart, man. Looking good. Anybody got any more American flags? Get them up.
Thank you. Thank you. This is awful hard to leave, and I don't think I can top it. Might as well just go back to Washington now. Okay, I won't. We'll be here. But listen, thank you all very much, and God bless you all very much. You've made us very happy. Thank you. Thank you. And we love all of you. Thank you. Thank you.
Of soil has fallen to the communist control. You know the result. I think that we are. As a matter of fact, we remember the whole record in Mayhem. And in the strength it takes to protect it.
Yeah.
And so we go to our work this evening knowing that all is not perfect in the world, but much is improved. Oh.
Four more years!
The Carter-Mondale administration left us. That our men and women in uniform, and God bless them, I think, for the best we've ever had. That's what he's there for. But the young fellow then said, drew himself up and said, Mr. Ambassador, will you tell the president, we're proud to be here, and we ain't scared of nothing.
President, come talk to us. The winners always like to talk.
You're okay, right there.
That's very courageous. Mr. President, let me ask you a question. How did you do last night? How did you do last night?
Boy, I was waiting for all of you to tell me.
Did you win, Mr. President? What do you think of Jeff Keith? Wait, you just coached
you. Said you won.
What do you think?
Is he coaching you again?
He says I won.
What do you say?
But it comes better now.
Well, seriously, don't you think you did a little better than Louisville?
Yes, I felt fine. I felt good about it. I was sorry there were some of the things that there wasn't time to respond to, but I think we're mistaken for that.
What would you have told us at the end of your summation had you finished it?
I was talking about the wonderful young people that we've met on campuses and high schools and some just out of school and going to work, and how wonderful they are, and the responsibility that my generation and the two generations between mine and
theirs have to do to
see that they have the same kind of country and hope and opportunity that we had growing up. And that was our responsibility.
But that letter, you were reading a letter. You started to read a letter.
I finished about that.
You didn't tell us what was in the letter.
You didn't say what was in the letter.
Well, it was a letter that had to do with our times and so forth, but then aimed at the slant. But I knew I was writing to people that, as I say, already knew the outcome 100 years from now.
You mean if they were alive?
Giving them personal observations and so forth in there, but hopefully something that might be interesting to be.
Why did you do better this time, sir?
What?
Why did you do better this time in Louisville?
Well, I think sometimes you go kind of flat, and I didn't feel as good in Louisville. I felt kind of flat, that maybe I'd over-crammed and so forth.
And last night, sir?
Last night, I felt fine.
They didn't brutalize you in the process this time, right?
I haven't felt brutalized since I've been here. Oh, once or twice meeting a few people, maybe.
Well, you're going to win the election now? You're going to win the election now?
You know me. I never say that. I'm superstitious.
We're going to play that tape from that 82 press conference about recalling submarine missiles, and we're going to compare your words with what you say you said.
Right. I was talking about the submarines and the airplanes, that they could be called back, in contrast to the inadvertent possibility of someone putting his thumb on the button and then finding out it was a mistake and no way to call it back. But you could call the submarines and the planes back before the launching point of the missile, and also the fact that those more conventional type weapons, they're not as destabilizing in people's minds, because we know from previous wars they can be intercepted and knocked down or stunned. But never, how would anyone would think that any reasonable human being would believe that you could turn a nuclear missile around and bring it home? I think that that shows a lack of intelligence on their part to believe that.
But see, that's what you said. I know you said that's not what you meant.
No, it was taken out of context, and I realize that all of you are on the record of having repeated it so often, but now try to find your way back off the end of the limb. I won't cut it off on you.
Why are you pulling out of Beirut? Why is the United States pulling out of Beirut?
I don't know what.
Why is the United States pulling out of Beirut?
Why didn't we pull out?
Why are you pulling out?
Why are we pulled out because the terrorist activity.
No, I mean, why are you pulling out now?
Why aren't we pulling out?
Why are you pulling out?
We're not pulling out. No. we've reduced all over the world. Our embassy staff streamlined them because our embassies are being threatened in every country in the world.
Is that why you're
But the thing is, I don't know what Mr. Mondale would do about this, but we're not going to hunker down and pull all of our representation of the world out in the face of terrorist acts. That's what they would like us to do.
But you are reducing personnel everywhere.
Yes, we're streamlining down so that there are few people at risk as possible, but maintaining our embassy contact.
You have to go now, Helen.
Yeah.
I'll throw you an orange.
Oh, this young man is an example of that generation I was talking about last night.
Please
also,
think of my friend,
and
they're
a wonderful Reagan. Generation.
How do you feel compared to after Lullaby?
Better.
Better? Why?
Nothing to do, I guess.
We didn't do anything to him this time, huh?
What did they do to Lenny last night?
All right, they hurt him.
Well, no, he got off to one side too heavy.